my first review will be Right Chemistry, or rather Right Formula, from Exora Games. Exora Games? How do you say the name? Why do they have to pick such a difficult name? But never mind. Why I'm reviewing them first is because they're from my home country, Singapore. And the game I'm reviewing is their first attempt to make a chemistry game. Now, when you open the screen, the game flashes at your face and you start straight away. Similar to the game Transistor, there is a simple tutorial and then you're off on your way. So what you have to do is you have to match the ions according to their charges, meaning that you pick an ion of charge 2 plus, you have to find ions of charge 2 minus. Okay? If you can't find charges of 2 minus, you got to find two individuals and ions or negative ions with a charge of 1 minus. And you combine them and get them. And this game literally is the same gameplay across three different presentations. What do I mean? The presentation 1 is the main game itself, where they put a few ions and you have to pick them. And then you have to name the ion. And that's presentation 2. Presentation 3 is something like a lucky draw. Presentation 3 is something like a lucky draw. And then you have to pick random ions. And then match them again. And then name them again. So, and what's good about this thing is that it teaches students to match ions according to their charges. It hopes that students will be more familiar with the different ions and their charges. And hopes to get them used to the different naming conventions. Okay, now I'm going to go through what this game doesn't do so well. Okay, all right, first off, if you look carefully, it's only one game mode with just three different backgrounds. Then that's it. You pick the ions, you name them. It doesn't go through the fundamental difficulties of students who study chemistry. So like, how do you know which element on the periodic table will form what ion? Another difficulty is that it tends to throw out very weird combination of chemicals and elements that you hardly see at the O levels, such as beryllium and sulfides. And another difficulty is that the time limit does not give time for students to appreciate which ions are suitable to form the relevant ionic compounds. Okay. So without further ado, I wish this game could have done more. But it is a step in the right direction, and I hope more developers will look into how they can educate students in the fields of chemistry, biology, and physics. To give Exora Studios props for attempting such a thing, to bring the world of education and the world of gaming together. So without further ado, this is Rosa Park signing off.